Hey everyone, today I'm going to show you how to edit a photo inside of Lightroom Classic. So I'm going to show you how to turn this photograph into this photograph. Now, if you're working in Photoshop, you can also open in Camera Raw and do the same thing. Okay, so here we are in the Develop module. The first thing we want to do is just kind of bring out some of the detail in here. So let's take our exposure and we're going to turn that up just a little bit. We don't want to go too far because we'll lose a lot in the sky and, of course, the sun. We want to keep that. So what we can do is we can pull back the highlights. This will recover the detail. Notice we see the beautiful color here now, and we start to see more of that. I'm going to pop the shadows just a little bit. So let's go just a touch, not too much. See what it's doing is just kind of opening it up a little bit down at the bottom here. Great. Next thing we want to do is we want to set our color temperature. Let's warm it up just a smidge, just taking it over a little bit. Great. Now, the next thing we need to do is really draw the viewer's eye into this photograph. So what I want to do now is crop. So let's choose the crop tool at the top. And maybe this is something I might want to put on Instagram. So I'm going to choose a 4x5. Even though this is likely to change in the future, they're going to be going for a 16:9 format. All right, let's just drag this down a little bit. And what we're doing is we're looking at a good place to position this. So what I'm doing here is I'm putting this grid over our point of interest, which is our sunsets. We're putting that into the thirds. And by the way, if you want to change this overlay, if you tap the O key, you can go through different types of overlays here. Now, you don't have to put it exactly on that point. Let's just pull it down a little bit, see a little bit more of that sky. And a little bit less of that building down here because that's not as interesting. Now, you might also notice that it's not quite level. So let's just hit the O key one more time until we get the grid. And then what I'm going to do is just drag this. And so what I'm doing is I'm looking at the sides of the building and trying to get it where it's properly straightened. So if you look down in this region here, see how those windows are now lining up? And I think that's looking a lot better. Now just hit the Enter key to apply that crop. So let's do a couple of things here to minimize some of these distractions. So I'm going to go to the masking panel, and I'm going to grab our linear gradient, and I'm going to drag it up from the bottom. Hold down the Shift key to constrain that. And then what we're going to do is just darken this slightly. So let's go to the exposure. And as we take it down, see what it does? It just brings the attention away from there, because otherwise these bright spots could grab your attention and distract you from what you really should be looking at. And I'm also going to take the temperature down just a touch, not a lot, just a little bit, because if that was in shadow, it would be a little bit cooler. Now let's do the same thing at the top. We're going to create a new mask. We're going to grab a linear gradient. And let's pull it down just a little bit. What I want to do is I want to add some drama to the sky, but I don't want to ruin this nice sunrise, these sun rays. So we're going to go down, we're going to grab the dehaze. And notice when you hit the dehaze, it really makes these clouds very, very dramatic. So let's pull it in, let's get a little bit of drama, and I'm actually going to just drag down a little bit more to allow it to cover more of the sky. Now these blacks are too dark, so take the blacks and we can compensate just by lightening them up just a little bit. There we go. Not so overbearing, and sometimes it even looks good to take this top and maybe even cool it. So I'm going to take the temperature back a little and see how it's adding so much drama to the sky here and really allowing this nice orange from this sunrise to really pop through. All right, we're almost there. There's a couple more things I want to do just for fun. We're going to click on the Create Mask, and this time we're going to choose a radial gradient. And so with the radial gradient, we're going to drag it out just around this area. Now, be careful not to go too far up into the sky. Let's keep it more in just in this kind of region here. Now, I want to feather a little bit more. So let's increase that feather. And what that does is it just gives us this very, very smooth blend. If I take the feather all the way down, it's a hard edge. So what I want to do is just brighten up this area just a little bit. So let's take the exposure. We're going to pop it. Let's take the temperature. We're going to warm it up a little bit more. And then what it's doing is just emphasizing a little bit more these sun rays here. And we're getting pretty close to being done. Now what I want to do is I want to work on the image as a whole. So we're just going to drag down a little bit and we can choose close, and that'll close the masking panel. And now when we make the adjustments, it's going to affect the entire image. All right. So one of the things I'm going to do is just give this a little pop of clarity. Not much, just a little push, just to kind of make things pop a little bit more. And I feel like that's looking quite nice. Let's have a look at the exposure. Like one final, do we want to add a little bit or not? It's always good to kind of look at that. And then possibly the temperature. We can just play around with that. And I think we're looking pretty good. Now, if you want to get it out, you just right click and then you choose export. Then under export, what I'm going to do is I'm going to do a JPEG and I'm going to output it at 1920. Make sure you click don't enlarge so it doesn't enlarge it. And then at this point here, I can export this out and it's something I could post on social media. So I hope you found this little workflow tutorial useful. Let me know in the comments underneath if you like this and you'd like to see more kind of tutorials like this. And if you're new, welcome to Photoshop Cafe. Hit that subscribe button, turn on notifications, and you won't miss any of my tutorials. And do me a favor, guys, hit that like button. What it does is it helps with the YouTube algorithm. And if you can't find it, it's on the YouTube page. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.